Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in Methodology Preaching Christianity. I'm going to give my deliberation on this recent debate in the Church of England about a woman bishops. Now, as I explained earlier, that these churches, they are corrupted one, and without apostles, roving preachers, they are dead, burying their dead, and they are working for mammon with the dog collar on and other things. They are hypocrite of the first degree. But most of the people are spiritually blind, and in the name of Jesus, they are fleecing people. So, blind guide leading the blind into the pit. So, they are leading the people into these sectarian riots and whatnot. So, if anybody he is in Christ, he will create love by preaching his word, gospel. Messianic Jews overpowered the church of God in the Judea region and brought in the rotten old cloth, the corrupted written Torah, into the churches. And for that, the apostles rebuked them. When the apostle used to visit them, see them reading the Torah like the old Jerusalem people were doing, making them drunk with the old wine instead of feeding them with this new wine in spirit, explaining to them the parable. They were teaching them the letters of the Old Testament, written Torah. And the Jews liked it, so that's why they flocked to it, whereas these sensible Gentiles, they laughed at them, and nobody will join them, you know, until they became corrupt and they had the start killing people who objected to them. Bishop threw the apostles out, and later on they killed them when they got Romans in their grips, when these Messianic Jews with their sycophant behavior, they got Romans into their grips, that Roman wanted soldiers, and they said, okay, we will supply you soldiers, and you kill those monks and those apostles who are criticizing us, who are pointing finger at us. These bishops, they became immoral, and for immorality they were known as waterless canals. So the monks in the monastery, they used to taunt them by calling them waterless canal, immoral people. So they killed them, you know, by putting them before animals and this and that. They burnt their books. And you can see, you know, they won't let anybody to copy it. They had the monopoly over this one until Martin Luther, you know, stood up. And he then led us to this freedom. So that's what Christ Jesus said, light came among his own. His own are the people of Jewish people. His light came his own. They loved darkness. They were so bad, you know, that they loved darkness. Jesus came to heal them, and their spiritually sick people wanted to kill him. That's why when Lazarus died, and he wanted to go back to see him, then his laborers told him, why you want to go there? Don't you know they want to kill you? And they hate you so much? He said, no, I have to go. And when he insisted, then everybody said, we also die with you. When a blind guide leads the blind, they fall into the pits of deaths, such as Holocaust, Crusade, sectarian riots, etc. They are all of the making of these Messianic Jews. It's the Messianic Jews who have corrupted the thing, that they are holding these Bible with the rotten old cloth, which is patched with the brand new cloth, the New Testament, the patch became worse. So they hardly understand the Bible, you know, or who created Adam and Eve. They don't know whether it is God or Yahweh. So they have no idea. But they put on these dog collars. And when you go to their churches, the other day, last Sunday, I went to the local church. And they were saying, Christ died. And all that nonsense they were talking. I told them, don't you read in the Bible that John said, Christ was in the beginning and he is forever? Yes, we read it. Then why you call Christ died? Who died on the cross then? They have no idea. Jesus died. Jesus was born. Christ is a title. Never born, never dying. So this is the stage of their learning. And I met one doctor, you know, medical doctor, who wanted to be studying theology, you know, to become a priest, dog collar priest, earning money like the other. But in his case, it is not the greed, it is his devotion. That devotion is blind. And when I gave him that, I'm also a retired lecturer, have this one and read it, you know, John's baptism. Then he said, you know, when I start, oh, I don't want to read it. You take it back. I said, no, you hold it and you have it, look through it, you will enjoy it. So it was, you know, he had no desire. Then I had just to request him to read it. So this is the degree of darkness. So the priest in the churches, they don't know what they are talking. All they talk, Lord Jesus Christ. They don't know that Jesus is not a Lord, he's a super servant. And he is Christ Jesus and not Jesus Christ. They don't know the difference between Jesus and Christ. So this is the degree, you know, we have to open the eyes of the people. We have to talk to them that this is not the way, this is the correct way to address Jesus. So it's all we have to make the effort, you know. But those people who are called to our Father, they are very few. That's why Jesus said, you know, many are called, few are chosen. So you have to have patience, you know. Don't be disappointed, but try to put the things right. So in this dark age, you cannot blame a third person, but you blame yourself for rejecting the light and following others in the manners of a blind. So Christ Jesus has brought to us golden age to earn salvation. He is the light. So we have to perceive his light and then to multiply it by preaching gospel. But if we don't do it, then we are to be blamed because we are part of the society. And if they suffer, we also will suffer, you know. So we should all make effort that we put light around us. We have the circle of light of our Father, and that light will protect you from Satan, who is the darkness. So if you live in a place and you preach gospel, you know, of our Father, then you will create agape. Agape is the divine love that only exists between twice born people. So once you are created agape, then you will enjoy. So let's see, you know, these Church of England, blind guides, how they fight with each other on the basis that they want woman priest, you know. A woman cannot teach the moral laws, but she can preach gospel. And so let's tell them that you can preach gospel, but not teach the scriptures.